It's time for the Dickey's Barbecue Coaches Show with Wiley Pirate head football coach, Jimmy Carter. Joining Coach Carter is Pirate host, Derek Draper.
Welcome to the Dickey's Barbecue Coaches Show with Wiley Pirate head coach, Jimmy Carter. And Coach, starting it up 6-5 on the season. Play. Go your way. It's North Forney. It seemed like it started out as a shootout, really. Yeah. At the end of the first quarter, it was tied up 14-14, and it was like, man, no one's playing defense. And so then at the halftime, it was 35-21, and so I don't know, it seemed hard to sustain the drives in the second quarter and also the rest of the game. What did you tell your guys at halftime and at the end of the game?
You know, at halftime, I told them, you know, we knew it was going to be a dog. And, you know, we were right in the middle of it. And, you know, we had a miscue there, you know, an interception in the end zone, or it's probably 28-28 at halftime. We still believed that we could win. And, you know, and we thought we had a good shot at it. And, you know, we dropped a pass, a wide open pass there kind of early in the third quarter. And, you know, just, you know, some things didn't go our way. And, you know, hats off to North Forney. You know, they're a good football team and a different style of football team than we've ever faced. And, you know, that quarterback is pretty fast, you know.
He was very fast on the edge. And so.
And, you know, at the end of the game, you know, I just told him I was proud of, you know, for the way they fought and the way they, you know, persevered throughout the season, you know, all year long, you know, to start out, you know, 0-2 in non-district. But, you know, those games, you know, we always feel like, you know, here at Wiley that those games prepare us, you know, for the playoff run and things like that, you know, just, you know. You know, come out Friday, but you know, I'm proud of this group of seniors as a special, you know, group of kids.
Yeah, and we'll talk about seniors a little bit. Just watching the game film, you know, who had some good plays offensively, and what did you feel that went well offensively for the Pirates?
Yeah, you know, I thought Jagger did another good job. You know, we had a couple of plays where, you know, draw him off sides. He threw a big ball to Martavion that Martavion went up and caught. And then, you know, the one who did the thing to Mitchell. And instead of throwing a fade ball, Mitchell, he threw a back shoulder fade to Mitchell. And Mitchell adjusted and made a good catch. You know, I thought both running backs, you know, ran the ball hard. You know, the offensive line, again, you know, can't talk about how well they've played this year, you know. You know, Michael Oyeka up in the.
And as far as the defensive side of the ball, what are some positive aspects defensive? Who had big games defensively?
You know, defensively, we knew it was going to be a physical game, and I think we matched their physicality, you know, between the tackles, that where they got on the edge, you know, just a little bit more speed than we had. But, you know, I thought in three defensive linemen, you know, Brady and Diego and JR, you know, played really well in there, you know, stuffing it up. And, you know, then Mark and Harrison were able to, you know, make some tackles.
It looks like you made some adjustments. You had four down linemen occasionally in there.
Yeah, we, so. You know, looking at what Rockwall did to him, you know, the week before and just kind of using a little bit of our strengths, you know, we used Jiroge in there as an outside linebacker type. You know, we knew that if we got in a situation where he had to stand up and go play in space, that he could do that. He's done it before. He is a converted linebacker to a D lineman. But, you know, I thought they did a really good job and, you know, had a little four-man front there.
So, talking about the seniors, how would you characterize this group, class of 2025, this group of seniors? You had a large group of seniors.
It's one of the biggest ones that I can remember in the last, you know, 10 or 12 years. You know, and just the way they interact with each other in the locker rooms, you know, and outside, this group is a very tight-knit group. You know, I thought they did a good job of accepting and teaching the sophomores, especially, that we had on the team this year. You know, a lot of times you can get some dissension there, you know, but I thought they did a really good job of taking them in. You know, that's one of the big things that we talk about. You know, it's a senior team. You know, it's their team, and that's each and every year. But, you know, you're going to need sophomores and juniors to go help you win football games. And I think they understood that, and they bought into it. And, you know, this group's going to be, you know, sorely missed. You know, Jagger's probably in the top five of, you know, quarterbacks at Wiley High School with career victories, you know, with 20 career victories. So, you know, that speaks fairly highly of him and his leadership skills.
So what will you miss most about this group?
You know, just the camaraderie that they brought, you know, to the locker room and to the field house. And, you know, and just the way that they were good leaders. You know, I think they left a good legacy.
Yeah, we at the end of a broadcast on Friday, we read through all the names of those. There's a lot, and especially if you look at the depth chart, especially defensive, man, it's all seniors.
Yeah,
and so there's a lot a lot of work. Speaking of that, when will you start working on the 2025 season?
Yesterday.
All right.
I mean, you know, you start thinking about it, you know, from here on, you know, thinking about, you know, these bits and pieces here and try to start putting the puzzle back together again. You know, it's just that's the fun part of the job, you know, is just trying to make the puzzle pieces fit all the time. And, you know, sometimes we get them wrong. Sometimes we get them right. So, you know, we're going to take a couple weeks off. You know, I told the coaches over the weekend, you know, it's time to reflect and refresh, you know, and you know, we just, you know, next season will be here before you know it. But, you know, we need some time to again, reflect on the year and celebrate, you know, the good things that we did. And then, you know, just kind of refresh ourselves. And, you know, same thing for the kids. You know, we're going to give them a couple weeks off. And, you know, we got kids going to basketball and wrestling. And you know, we'll be gearing up for track and baseball season. And you know, and then hitting the weight room pretty hard. And so, you know, but, you know, their bodies need a little bit of time to heal. Their minds need, you know, time, just time away, you know, does the body good.
Yeah. So as far as this year goes, anybody you want to thank, as you know, I know you have a lot of people behind the scenes that do a lot of things.
You know, I like to thank all of our sponsors. You know, I think we've read them off several times this year. You know, they do a lot of commercials. You know, it's just, you know, with the new stickers that we put on the helmets this year, you know, we wouldn't be able to do things like that without those guys, you know, supporting us and, you know, things that the kids, you know, want, need, you know, braces and, you know, just all kinds of different things, little things that come up. You know, I'd like to thank you and the broadcast team, you know, for doing a great job. I know my dad appreciates it, you know, not being able to be here, but being able to listen. So, you know, that's kind of cool. You know, I'd like to thank our senior mom, Miss Joanna Osborne. You know, she's done a great job this year, you know, of getting the parents involved and getting, you know, snacks for the underclassmen and, you know, and setting up meals for the varsity kids and things like that. So, you know, just it's, you know, I guess a lot of times I get the credit and the backlash, you know, if things don't go right. But, you know, there's a lot of people, you know, that it takes to run a football program, you know, even a high school football program. You know, everybody hears about the NFL and college teams and all the support staff they have, you know. But, you know, even in high school, you know, it takes a village to run it.
Yeah, a lot of cogs in the wheel. That's,
yes,
that's for sure.
Yeah.
Well, that wraps it up for the 2024 season. And thank you for tuning in this season to watch the Dickey's Barbecue Coaches Show. And we look forward to a 2025 season. And thank you, Coach. And for Coach Carter, I'm Derek Drake. Thanks for watching.
Amo.
Since 1941, Dickey's Barbecue Pit has been smoking the very best quality meats for 14 hours every day. It's how Mr. Dickey did it, and it's how we still do it in every Dickey's restaurant across America. Come in and see us or visit Dickey's.com.